Hey everybody, it's Cyberg War. How you guys doing? All right, I'm gonna do a little thing I haven't done in a long time. I'm just gonna start fresh. I'm gonna do just a short video using an Aurora and see how much money I can make without spending any money and without using any armor or anything that I can't procure while I'm out. So let's see, I have 416,573 AUEC, and I will not be using any of it to make money. So I'm going to go out and loot. I'm going to go out and do missions. I'm going to go out and see what I can find. I'm going to sell items and just see how much money I can make without spending a penny and using any kind of bought armor or anything. So, like, only thing I have on me right now is a pistol that you start out with, the undersuit you start out with, and the helmet you start out with. Oh god, I hope my pistol has ammo in it. Well, I guess we'll find out, right? But yep, so first things first, I'm gonna hit a mining outpost and see what I can find. So I'll see you at the ship. All right, so like I said, everything's stocked. This is basically what you would start out with if you had nothing in your inventory. I didn't even buy any ammo for my gun, but I can see that there's 30 rounds in there. So I'll have a pistol. Yeah, anything I find along the way, I'll keep. So if I find armor, if I find, I'll equip it. If I find clothing, if I find food, anything, I'll be storing it and selling it. Just to see how much. Oh, I'm sitting down. My Aurora will be completely stocked now, and won't have any special weapons on it, no special engines, anything. The Aurora MR is basically just a starter ship, so you know, this is not going to be like one of those zero to hero things. It's just a little test I like to do for myself, see how much money I can make without any fancy equipment, help, special ships, anything. So like I said, I got 416,573 AUEC. So we'll see how much money I have at the end of the video. Alright, and if at any point I have to spend any credits, mission will fail. I'm basically playing like I have zero cash. I guess if there's a 30k or something, or the server crashes, I will figure it out from there. But get the ship started up. All right, my first destination is gonna be what would be a good place to go? Let's go to Lyria. So I'm leaving Arcorp, gonna go to Lyria. I can't go to... Okay, let's just go to Walla then. There's more mining stations on Walla anyway. So, gonna call the hangars. Doors are opening. Yeah, so I'm gonna hit the mining outpost and see what I can't find there and loot. Because they got loot boxes just hanging around, doing nothing. I might be able to procure a multi-tool, some armor. You never know. Stuff I'll need to wear for protection. Stuff I can sell. If I become stranded, that'll fail the mission too, I guess. Alright. Our first stop, should I go to Shady Glen? No, I'm not going to Good Times, I don't have, Arc Route 56, let's go see what's there. Alright, so I want to park, I don't really like to park on the pad when I got such a small ship, because a big ship might come in wanting to buy cargo or something. So, to be considerate of other players, especially the hardworking truckers. I'm gonna park right here. Turn off my ship. Get out. So I'm gonna hit all the buildings that are here. Look for the boxes to loot. Put everything in local inventory and then transfer it. Oh my god, there's nothing here. Oh, here's a box. Transfer to local inventory and then transfer to my ship. Okay, so we got three tractor beams. Dang. The boots. I'm just gonna move all and I'm gonna take this out because I'm not dealing with fruit. But now I got food. Look at that. I got one. I got five bottles of liquids and one snack. Oh. Can't loot that now because someone looted it. So we are. That bug's back. That sucks. This might be difficult. I like to walk slowly out of these exits and up and down the stairs because the wind could be blowing and I wouldn't realize it and I could get thrown around and knocked out or even killed. And I don't have the money to pay for medical rescue. So. All right, here's a red box. Hopefully there's some armor in there, something good. Look at that. Got some arms ready. Oh, this helmet right here goes 1,500 credits. These other helmets should net a few hundred each. The gray boxes usually have the lower price stuff, but you can find some decent jackets in here that go for money. All right, take the gloves. Oh, what's that? Ambra suit. I'm gonna sell that. I'm probably not gonna spend time selling the food, but I'm gonna put some on my ship so I don't die. All right. Oh, another tractor beam. Oh, and a multi-tool. All right. That's going right on my body, and so's. Oh, and it has a Cambio Light SRT attachment. That's for hand salvaging. Lifeguard medical. Take the clothing. Any of this stuff worth money? Not really. I mean, if you want, you could sell it all and probably get maybe 100 credits. Might just take way too long for the return, but it's good stuff to put inside your ship. So you always have food and flares and whatnot inside. All right. So all I have is armor for my arms. Whoa, that's weird. All right, so. That building's done. There's two more buildings across the way. All right, another gray box. These suits, I forgot what they sell for, 300 or 400. Hey, look at that. Couple more multi-tools, a helmet, worker's helmet, beanie, shoes. Flares aren't worth much. I mean, I forgot what they're worth. They're worth like 16 credits. But these little white things, I forgot what they're worth too. But I'm going to sell them. We'll find out when I go to sell them. Ranta dung is worth like 40. At least it was. I don't know what it's currently going for. Nothing in there. Man, look at all these multi-tools I'm finding. These things cost thousands of credits each. And I've got 1, 2, 3. I picked up 3 plus 4 heads. I mean, that adds up. That saves you money right there. Picking them up out here. Do it all day long. This gray box here. I hope I get some cool fraction jackets. Those go for like 1500 a piece. ATI jacket blue. I don't know what that's worth. We'll find out though. More tractor beam heads. And then that. I'm going to stack them all now so when I sell them later, it's much easier. Oh, another red box. All right. Let's hope there's something good in here. New arms. Okay. We'll take those. Three helmets. Hey, these helmets add up to a lot of cash. All right. We're clear here. Checked all the places. Well, there's a red box and a gray box in here. Cool. Same arms I already have, so I got an extra set now. Novikov helmet. There we go. Actually, I'm gonna switch helmets to that. Maybe I'll find a complete arrow set. That helmet offers a little more protection. Oh, here we go. Faction jacket. Teal. I think that's like 1500 credits. And then we'll take those medical attachments. We'll take the mining attachments. Put those on there. Put those on there. That way when I go to sell them, it's easy. Can't equip the yellow flare, but hey, not finding anything left behind by other players. So I think I'm just gonna do a series with this, and I'm just gonna roll with my total. Keep a total cost of deductions and stuff while I run the series, because I obviously can't get rid of the money I have, but I won't use any of the money while I do the series. So I'll keep rolling in the same stocked out ship. I'll keep the same armor and everything. It'll be a continuation of what I've already been doing. Even though I'll be playing with my Oregon stuff, doing other stuff. All right, let's hope there's an internal inventory in the vehicle. All right, there is. 650K, that's not much. Wow, I'm over half full already just from this one station. Okay. Let's go to another one. Let's go to Shady Glen to see if we can find anything there. Shady Glen is sometimes a good place to find weapons. Usually have a few loot crates full of just weapons. Also, coming in, you might encounter some NPCs, so be aware. They might be hanging out in the skies. So I want to be quick here, because an NPCs could spawn in while I'm inside, so I just want to get the stuff as quickly as possible and get out. Alright, I'm just going to leave the door open. Yes, I do have to run back to the ship. Nothing, 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 nothing. I run all the way back here. Oh, there's med guns. You can sell this stuff for good money. Take those. I'll take that. So I have them in my ship. No red boxes anywhere. Oh, here we go. Loot this. Should be some hacking chips in here and multi-tools and knife. I'm only going to take the SK8 knife because that's worth 600 credits. When I sell it. Hey, Cubby Blast, there we go. Red box. He's something good. He's something good. Some arms, shotgun, a couple helmets. And, oops. Changed helmets. Oh well. I'll just wear the one I got now. But I took my old one and put it back in inventory. Alright, no boxes. Well, just the boxes are usually on the ground here. Alright. We're out of here. Get back in the ship before we get blown up. I've been attacked a lot here. Oh shit. I got the wrong kind of helmet on. There we go. Ah, crumb. I didn't realize that was a helmet with no mask. It's all good. I'm better now. Bring up the internal ship inventory and the local inventory. I'm just going to move all. All right, 61%. We're going to keep rolling. Where can we head to now? Let's go to 45 or 61. Let's go to 61. Not a lot of people go out there. Might find something good. So, same tactics as the last base. I'm gonna land over here by the commodities area. That's where that tower is right there. That's where you buy and sell commodities at the kiosk. I always just tend to park next to it. Xenothreat's another way to make a lot of money. Holy cow. You don't even have to really get involved. You just literally take the mission, fly out the Mecha 1, go to where it says report for duty and stand there. And then fly back to Mecha 1 and stand there and make 5,000 credits like every couple minutes. Anything good? Oh, alright. Multi-tool shoes. Walla's got very high winds, so be careful entering and exiting doors. Like, I'm running full blast right now, and the wind's pushing me so tight, so hard, it's hard to, like, move. Hey, another Ambrose suit. I don't remember exactly what they're worth. We'll find out, but I know they were worth 300 or 400. Maybe like 380 or 360. Gonna leave the food and fruit. No red crate here. Wow, a lot of stuff. Another jacket. Pants, lovies. I hope this all fits in my ship. I think I'll be heading back to Area 18 after this thing. After this mining outpost. Man, my brain is really slow today. All right. It happens when you get old. I'm gonna go put this stuff in the ship, see how much room I have left, and then go hit the other two buildings. Yeah, where I used to be, alright, at 79% now. Okay. I got room for more. I'm telling you, these multi-tools are going to add up to some good cash. There we go. Red armor. Helmets. Whatever. Give me a chest piece. Oh, undersuit. All right, a couple helmets. Hey, that's money. That's probably like 2K right there. And this is zero investment other than time. So if I die, I don't lose any money. I mean, I'd lose the money I would have made, but I'm not losing any investment. It's like zero risk and investment risk. Ooh, some nice pants. Plus I'll have food and, you know, multi-tools if I want. I mean, I could literally start the whole game by doing this from zero credits. And then just go on into the verse with everything I'll ever need. Now that I have a shotgun, a couple magazines, I can go do bunker missions. I could do Siege of Orison. I got food, so I don't have to buy that. I got armor. I'll eventually have a full set, even though it doesn't match. I even have clothes to wear if I want. Come on now. Jacket. Another Umbra suit. Man, they give those things out like frickin' flares. Wow, that's a lot of stuff. Okay, I think we're good. Let's go back to Area 18 and sell all this. See how much money I made. Alright, I thought I was at 81% before. Well, I'm at 96% now. I just want to triple check that it went into inventory with the server running really low. Who knows? All right. Ship is basically full. I could probably throw another couple undersuits in here or one helmet. I'm just going to leave everything in the ship so it doesn't get intermingled with stuff in my normal inventory. But I don't sell anything on accident. All right, and then all in all, I've spent about 40 minutes so far, but I didn't spend any of my own money. I haven't gone into combat. I haven't done anything. I got a ship full of loot. I got weapons. I got armor. All right, so I'm just going to stack everything in inventory. So if, when I go to sell it, and man, God, camera. All right, let's filter armor. Look at that. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 helmets, 3 sets of arms, 1 undersuit. Look at all this clothing. That's going to make me some money. I got 1 knife. Look at all this stuff here. That's just from hitting 2 stations and a farm. So people, don't tell me you can't loot your way to financial success in this game with no investment other than time. I wish you could stack the multi-tools, but you can only stack them if you buy them, so they'll be stacked when you bought like 20 of them at once. But you can stack the attachments and the smaller things. Ammo. Got 2 of those. Got some sustenance. Alright. So I'll sell everything except for probably the ammo and the sustenance. And maybe a med gun. I might keep a med gun on me. All right, so I left all the loot in my ship, and we're going to go sell it. And I have half an armor set. I will eventually find a torso and some legs. All Here, I'm gonna go actually stop at the hospital first and sell the medical stuff that's in my ship. If the ASAP terminal will cooperate. Or commerce terminal, not ASAP. Alright, let's go to sell. We're gonna select the Aurora MR. Wow, there's a lot of stuff to sell. Okay, let's quick sell tractor beams. Actually, I'm not gonna quick sell. I'm gonna see if I can sell more than one at a time. Otherwise, I'm gonna be here all day. Got 11 of those. See if it'll actually go through. Ooh, transaction complete. All right. Look at, I'm getting 96 credits for that. 100 credits for that. 160 credits for that one. 280. So I got a lot of stuff to sell. Got 23 of those. Wow. It's actually adding to my total up here. All right. Yeah, 18 of those. And I'll just quick sell the multi-tools. Oh, it failed. Bye. Failures are at a minimum. I can try and sell it in another store too. If worse comes to worse, I'll just keep it on the ship and have a backup. I know I have two of these, so I'm just going to sell one. Oh, that failed. Okay. For your convenience, there are sanitizing stations located throughout the facility. That failed. Stop the spread of germs. That succeeded. Alright. Well, I'm not going to sell anything else here. But let's see right now. What did I just make off multi-tools? So I'm at 425,391. All right, so 425, 391 minus, what did I start out with? 416, 573 equals, that was 88.18 just in medical stuff I sold. 8,818 credits. And yeah, my math would have been way off. And I still got the more expensive stuff to sell. So I'm going to head over to Cubby Bear. Or Cubby Blast, not Cubby Bear. Cubby Bear's a bar here in Chicago. I'm gonna head over to Cubby Blast and sell what I can here. Probably just be the armor and undersuits. And even if the stuff's not worth anything, I'm just gonna throw it in my local inventory. All right, look at that. 220 credits. 1.7 for that one helmet. 450. Another 1.5. Another 1.5. I got a lot of stuff. The extra set of Errol arms I found. That was 210 credits. The Tiger Claws, 530 credits that I found in that one box. And I have two of them, so I'm selling the other one. That's 1,060 credits. 380 credits for one of them. I forgot what those are called. Oracle helmets. I think I had a couple of them. I'm selling the other one. The helmet I started out with is worth 720. I'm going to sell that because I got the new Errol. That Odyssey helmet's red is worth, I forgot what it was. That Argus helmet that almost killed me in the airlock is worth 840. Force Flex underseat blue, black, tan. And like, if I really want to, I can sell some of this food. Oh, I forgot about the combat knife. Definitely gonna sell that. That's 600 credits. I got the pyro multi-tool. Let's see if I can sell that here or if it's still fail. Yeah, it's failed. Okay, for some reason it's bugged. Here we go. I got two of these on the ship. Look at these, are 57. I got two of those that would, you know, if I want to sell those, I can. I got that other pyramid medical device on the ship. Well, let's quick sell it. I'll find more. Yep, that failed too. Okay, well, that's everything on the ship I'm gonna sell here, and then I'm gonna go over to Cassava outlet, sell all the clothing I got on there, because I mean there's a lot of clothing. Oh, I didn't see how much I made there. 425, 391. So we got 441, 559 minus my previous, which was 425, 391. That was 16,000 in gear alone. 16,168. Basically 25,000 profit for going to the moon and back to do nothing but other intake stuff. All right, we're going to sell stuff from the Aurora MR. Look at that. That one jacket, 1,900 credits. Thank you.
I'm not even supposed to be here today.
This hat, 140. And the funny thing about clothing is if you go to different systems, they're worth different amounts because they may be in style more there and in demand more than they are in this system. So if I took them, okay, I went to Microtech with these hats, I might get like 190 credits for it, or even 200. And so on, you know, for each individual item. You know, I know those Stratus pants would sell for more out of Microtech. All right, that hat's worth nothing, but I'm selling it anyway. I don't want it. Look at gloves are 90 credits. Earned 60 credits for those gloves. 90 credits. I wish you could stack clothes and get rid of them all at once. Or they have a sell all button. That would be great. But the systems are still getting ironed out, so I don't think they want to dump all that kind of data at once. ATI jacket, 680. That one ATI jacket, though, just because of the color of it, was worth a lot more. Look at these boots, 70, 70. I mean, I still got all this stuff to sell. Well, minus the food. That Pathfinder pop-up helmet, is worth nothing. It might be worth something on Hurston because they use them there, but probably like 40 or 50 credits. But it's not worth anything here at R-Corp. I'm just going to keep selling until I'm done here and got a total. Oh yeah, what are those Umbra seats worth? $390 each. I picked up four of them, so that's like what, a little over $1,500. Uh-oh, transactions are taking a long time now. I might be going too fast, or the server's having issues. Just gonna keep it open here so it completes or if something happens. Oh, I wish they would. There we go. Transaction success. Yes. Go. I wish they would turn off Xeno threat.
Supposed to be here today.
Last couple items. So many pairs of shoes. All right, and then I'll keep the rest because if you look, everything's sold except drinks out of the Aurora. What's my total now? 451,305. Wow. All right, let's tally this up. Let me get out of the kiosk so I can actually. 451. What was it, 305? 451,305. Okay. Minus my initial starting total of 416,573 equals 34,732 credits. Just for going to three places on Walla. And I have half of a suit. I can't get out of this. And I have half a suit. So I got a new helmet. I got arms. I got ammo. I got a shotgun. I got a multi-tool. I got food. And I still have a couple med guns and another multi-tool in the ship. So that would have been like another 1,000 credits right there. Yeah, 34,732. I'd say for about half hour's worth of work with no investment other than getting out there. Didn't spend a penny. You can do this, people. There's no reason to be broke in this game. You do that mission I just did twice, three times. You got 100, maybe 120K. Results may vary depending on what you find. But, don't act like you can't make money in this game. I just made a crap load. And I'm probably going to go do a bunker mission after this and make more and get a bunch of loot. So, have fun. I'm out. Cyborg War loves you guys. Be safe in the verse. Remember to hit the like, subscribe. Follow me over on the TikTok and the Tweety and the whatever that thing's called. The Facer book. The Book of Faces. And then yeah, man. Oh, and Twitch, dude. I live stream on Twitch. Follow me over there. It looks like I don't live stream because my VODs are turned off, but I do. So that's why you might see it there and they're like, oh, he isn't live streamed in a while. I've tried to live stream as much as possible with my schedule and everything. It's a little hard, but I'm there. I try to get a couple times a weekend. I'll catch you guys later. Peace out. Make that money, man. See how easy it was? If I can do it, you can do it.